So guys, what's school gonna be about today?
It's gonna be about the benefits of public transit and why they are a counter weapon against car dependency, oil dependency and aviation dependency.
Oh well, that makes sense, because the crisis of people being forced into endless debts of oil, car and aviation dependency is dead serious.
Okay guys, so today, we'll be out on a field trip with the second and third graders. That means you guys will be going with the Sugar Rush Racers on a train together. We'll be going to Contemporaryville to have some fun activities and learn social skills with the people there. And as the Central Education Institute's policy goes, no homework is allowed, so you all can go play games, socialize with your family and neighbors, and learn anything you guys want.
Hi, Melody and Charlotte. Anything exciting for school?
Hello, Mother. We're going out for a field trip to Contemporaryville, and we want to show our friends our new costumes. These costumes are for show, and maybe as uniforms in case we want to pilot trains again.
Oh, I see. Well, make sure to tell me if you guys want to, okay? Also, Ringo came up with a new uniform policy.
Thanks for coming to this field trip. I, Professor Felix with Coach Sergeant Calhoun, Ms. Myers and Ms. Bella, as well as Ms. Emily and Mr. Lopez will be your tour guides. We will be taking this limited super express train which stops at Kingswood City, Rockford Heights, Waterfront Beach, and terminates at Contemporaryville.
Professor, this train is named Sunrise Comet, and is one of the many trains which uses the livery resembling that of the first generation Eurostar trains.
Okay, I had no idea that these trains have names. Usually they are only known by the numbers, but if the company named the trains themselves, then I guess it's all right.
All right, it's almost time for boarding, everyone.
Ugh, I can't believe we are going on a boring field trip to Contemporaryville just to have some stupid social fun activities. And to add insult to injury, we are forced to take this boring train. Why can't we drive electric cars instead?
Oh, I fucking agree, Caillou. Let's teach these assholes a lesson that they should depend on cars and planes for long trips.
Well, I have an idea. Let's burn those garbage over there, and when there's a fire, this menacing thing will stop and cause all sorts of fucking confusion and delay.
Good idea, little Bill. Let's do this shit.
Go animate logic activate.
Guys, let's activate the fire alarm and emergency button.
Will you stop the train while I go check the emergency?
Roger that, Captain.
Mother, Myers, there's a fire.
Okay, Justin, lead the way.
Dear passengers and crew, I would like to thank you for evacuating in order and being alive. I have called the rescue team to take Sunrise Comet to the rolling stock facility for further investigations and repairs, and based on the surveillance camera, it turns out that three troublemakers have set some of the recycling bins on fire.
And it was actually Caillou, Dora the Explorer, and Little Bill. And don't worry, they have been dealt with. And in a surprising turn of events, those three troublemakers have said rude and nasty remarks to public transit and are lobbying car and aviation industries for intercity travel, which are actually harmful to the environment.
Honestly, I'm not surprised, Captain Amity. They are nowadays demanding car dependency, which is already dangerous against humanity. Cars should be only used as motorsports racers and leisure vehicles, not daily commute.
I hope they will be dealt with as usual. because what they did had caused confusion and delay, and I bet this will make headlines on the news.
We will have to postpone our field trip for tomorrow, so right now, we will be heading back to Business Friendopolis.
And in that case, class is dismissed.
Anyway, Melody, what's with the funny outfits?
Oh, just costumes.
Not trying to be awkward or something.
So, what do you want us to do now?
Maybe some races or something. I gotta get back on the wheels. And Justin and Dylan, we're cool, alright?
Sure, whatever.
Really, Swizzle? This is how we end our rivalry with them?
Anyway, has everyone noticed that Catherine had betrayed Dave and became literally a Karen?
Also, I heard she kidnapped gangbangers. What a bitch.
Oh my gosh, I had no idea about Catherine becoming a troublemaker. Sucks to be her then.
Yeah, I don't want her to boss us around anymore.
I wonder what path will this Catherine person take, and if she goes a path no one wants to go to, then she will have another thing coming.
And if she does, then fate will decide what to do with her.
Say, what fate will Chibi Lily and her cute girlfriends follow?
Well, we just wait and see what path they will take, and what fate will they fall into, or what destiny they will serve.
Welcome to Go Animate News, we are live from studio. Breaking news, the southeast section of Starlight Railway's high-speed main line has been disrupted by three troublemakers Caillou, Dora the Explorer, and Little Bill setting fire on one of the trains, Sunrise Comet, which leads to a 30-minute delay on subsequent trains. However, thankfully the passengers and crew all survived and there are no injuries or fatalities and they will be either refunded or sent to another train and the three troublemakers will be paying the damages to Sunrise Comet.
So to the families of Caillou, Dora and Little Bill, you won't have to pay for the damages, only your troublemaking children will, or for a better idea, they will be arrested until a certain event happens. In other news, Catherine Johnson, the ex-wife of the formerly infamous Dave the Childish Dad, has been reported kidnapping gangbangers hailing from Auburn Creek City in the southwest.
Caillou, Dora and Little Bill, for setting Sunrise Comet the bullet train on fire that leads to half an hour of subsequent delays on the Starlight Railway's high-speed main line. You three losers are so extremely grounded until Chris Animate uploads another video.
This means you three will not be allowed to hang out with the troublemakers, not allowed to demand car dependency which is extremely hostile against livelihoods, not allowed to sabotage any more trains, and not allowed to have recess at school as you three will be put on in school suspension until Chris Animate's next video gets uploaded.
You three should be ashamed of yourselves for damaging such a prestigious train that led to delays on subsequent trains. You know that the people of Go Animate Land in this continent of Pacifica rely on trains to commute, as they prefer clean energy trains instead of dirty fossil fuels, electric cars and electric SUVs unlike the United States of America and Canada, because climate change is worsened because of cars and planes being overused for travels.
And to make sure you three are not escaping punishment, the Go Animate Super Police Unit will have you three arrested for vandalism and sabotage. So, have a terrible day in jail, and you will be transported to school by the police.
We did not ask for us whole troublemakers like your pathetic bitches. I wish that in a was our daughter instead of a pathetic excuse of an explorer like you, Dora Marquez. You are a disgrace to our family, but we will never stop until you start to get your act together.
And as for you, Little Bill, we hope you learn your lesson this time and for you to stop acting like a gangster, because your misbehavior is not going to be good for our reputation. By the time Chris Animate uploads another video and you are let go from jail, you three better behave yourselves or this grounding cycle will never end.
Take these miserable bastards away, officers. We don't want to see their faces until they are free from jail.
Right away, Brenda, come on boys, let's take these fools den down.
This is bullfuck.